Hi, I'm Fiona Kazazi-Jacuzzi, and I'll be explaining if Canada is a better country now than before. Canada is a big country with so much history, good or bad, over the past 150 years. Now, the question is Canada a better country now than it was before? In the early 20th century, many people did not welcome other cultures in Canada, and Canada back then was a racist country even though the government does not really say it was. If you're anything other than white in Canada back then, you lived a pretty difficult life. Several decades later, Canada has become a very diverse and welcoming country to other customs. Canada has changed its terrible ways in the past, but still has an effect on some of those cultural groups who have been affected. Black Canadians were one of the cultural groups that have been affected in the past. Black people were excluded from many of the Canadian customs. One example is World War I. Black volunteers were rejected to participate in the First World War until World War II is when they were allowed to be in the regular army and be accepted in officer corps. Later on in the years, the Ku Klux Klan was founded, which is a white supremacist hate group whose primary target is African Americans and African Canadians. This became a big thing in Amherstburg, Ontario. The KKK set a cross on fire at one of the Black Baptist churches in that city. They had been segregated in schools and in stores, washrooms, and so many other places. Racism to African Canadians was still a big thing during this time until Prime Minister Trudeau introduced Canada's multicultural policy. Black people in Canada have now so many opportunities today, but still face police brutality because of the color of their skin. Now there are protests all over the country because Black Lives Matter. We as Canadians have a voice, and we must use this voice to help today's society. We have come a long way from 100 years ago today. Aboriginals is also another minority group in Canada that has been treated terribly in Canada for several hundred years. First Nations children all over the country have been forced to attend residential schools until the year 1996. Until then, residential schools eliminated all aspects of Aboriginal culture and assimilated Aboriginal children into Euro-Canadian culture. Teachers there would sexually assault young females attending the school. They would also sometimes not feed the children, and many of the times children would catch illnesses like tuberculosis because of bad conditions of the residential schools. But that wasn't all for Aboriginal peoples. Aboriginals in Canada could not vote until the year 1960, which was 60 years ago. Back in 1867, they were allowed to vote but had to give up their Indian status. It was only until 1960 when they could vote without losing their Indian status. In 1969, the Minister of Indian Affairs at that time produced the White Paper. This white paper that he produced suggested that federal government ended treaty obligations to First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples. The plan was basically to dissolve the Department of Indian Affairs and abolish the Indian Act. This meant that all Aboriginals across the country would lose their Indian status and would be treated like any other minority in Canada at that time. They would lose their land and reserves. Thankfully, the government did not go through with this idea. Still in the 21st century, Aboriginals were still not getting the rights they deserved. In 2012, the Idle No More movement was created. It was called on all people to join in a peaceful revolution to honor Indigenous sovereignty and to protect the land and water. This movement will still continue to pressure government and industry to protect the environment. Aboriginals never had a voice in Canada back then, but in today's society they do, and they are using it for good. Another group in Canada that suffered for many years is females in 20th century Canada. Women back then couldn't do nearly half the stuff men did back in the 1900s. All women did was be a housewife while their husbands supported their families. Some other jobs women had in the 1900s were being a teacher, nurse, secretary, and store clerk, but those jobs didn't pay very much. It was only until World War I when women were recruited to do hard labor jobs because many men went to fight in the war. But women working these labor-heavy jobs only lasted for a short amount of time. Up until the year 1929, women in Canada did not have any rights and were not recognized as persons. It was until the Famous Five that changed that. The five women, Emily Murphy, Irene Marriott Parlby, Nellie Mooney McClung, Louis Crummy McKinney, and Henrietta Muir Edwards, decided to test the law by asking the Supreme Court of Canada whether or not the word persons applied to women in Section 24 of the British North America Act. It took the Supreme Court 5 weeks to render its decision. The answer was no, it did not. So the famous five went to Britain to ask the Supreme Court if women could be recognized as a person, if women could vote and be elected for the House of Commons. In the year 1927, women can now do all these things thanks to the famous five. 21st century Canada has come a long way from where it was before. Canada now has become a better and safer place where people can express their religion, sexuality, and race without being criticized. Black rights are a big thing now that most people in Canada are supporting, even Prime Minister Trudeau. In 2008, former Prime Minister Stephen Harper apologized on behalf of the Canadian government to all their surviving residential school survivors. Women in Canada have so many more rights now than they did 50 to 100 years ago. This country does still need some improvements, but I think Canada is a better country now than it was before.